Was it over here? That one's up there.
Those ones are already up on the hill.
There was one there. It sounded like two there and two over there. Probably should set the decoys up on it and sit down like soon.
He's right there. It's probably still about 100 yards. I don't know how much closer we want to get, though. We could start harping on the call.
I mean, it's so still. You're back there a little bit farther than me. Yeah, he's got to be just too high on that. Dave just said this, but yeah, I think this group of Jakes that came in fired off. Might have ran our long beard off because he was right there. He committed like 5 more yards. He would have definitely been locked onto the decoys. We should have been right in the game. But that group of Jakes came in barking their head off. And he kind of shut up after that. So we got to reset up, I think. Going back. I gotta get up like on our other piece of what, you know.
Right. You gotta go back to where they're headed.
Way up there. Those damn Jakes. They're gonna make us walk. They're gonna make us work.
That bird was right there. He was, what, 60 yards? 80?
Yeah, 60.
60, 70 yards. Yeah, we're just on the downslope of this hill on this side.
I knew it.
And I don't think he saw the decoys before those Jakes came in, and he was gobbling, and those Jakes came from a long way away, all the way to him.
He didn't commit coming down into this.
No, he didn't commit coming down into here. But he was just on the crest of the hill. And I think the decoys are, I mean, see, they're down in this hill on this logging road. I just don't think you could see them. But man, our plan worked. We were in the backyard this morning, and we said we were gonna wait to hear him gobble, and as soon as he started gobbling, we were gonna go to him. And we had to have gotten within 150 yards max of where he was roosting, and we had him coming. There's a lot of birds back here today. It's crazy.
There's just something different about putting way back in the woods.
In the deep timber. Yeah, there's
no house, there's no. I was just talking about him, like, it's not the same. Just getting back, and it's you and them. It's you and them in the woods.
It's you and them in their home territory. They have the advantage.
Most of the time they win. Set these decoys up so that if these turkeys come into this field, no matter where they come from, they're gonna see them.
Well, we reset up here. We're actually across the street from where we were this morning. This is the backside of our main food plot, and you can see a couple birds strutting back here, just driving down the road, and my dad seen a couple birds strutting back here. So we just got set up, and literally we didn't even get set up. We had a hen come from across the field right into the decoys, and she fed around for about 10-15 minutes. But this is a good spot. They peek out into this field, and you just never know what could happen. These decoys already lured that hen in. Maybe we can lure in a gabbler. Set out for one this morning. We were on them early. Quieted down. Shit's about to heat back up.
turkey's uno.
More than that.
Well, today.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, in New York, they're undefeated. Literally.
They are?
They're undefeated. They're like the Harlem Globetrotters. And we're the Queens, something. We're not good. Now, we had them going this morning. We were right up on them. We were kind of in a little bit of a tough spot. Didn't want to get too risky and go spook them. But we were kind of right on the edge of the cover, and he just wouldn't come in there. And then the Jakes got them all
hand-flustered.
Squirrely. And they just roundabouted us. We're going to be back in a couple days. Maybe not even.